Welcome to the university studies of power system protection. Today we have the expert of Madhusudan Sadia sir. He has completed his bachelor from MSc University in 1984, and he has almost the experience of about 35 years of experience in JETCO, and he has completed. He has retired as a superintendent engineer. He has experience in a 400 kV ASO substation, Bharuch substation. Also, he is the deputy engineer for the SS maintenance. So, I welcome you to Swadhyay sir to continue our webinar series. Welcome, sir.
Good morning. Am I audible to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Once again, I welcome all of you in the webinar of protection of transmission line. Last time on 10th May, we had covered some of the preliminary part of the backup and distance protection. Now we'll continue from where we had left. So this is the slide which will start today onwards, from this onwards. Now, what is the plug setting and time dial multiplier? So how it works, that we'll see here in this slide. So this is the old type of conventional backup relay, that is directional overcurrent relay, inverse type. CDD. We had discussed what is inverse, that is IDMC characteristics in last lecture. Now there are three things in setting here. One is a plus setting. This is the plus setting. Second is a time dial, and third is a time multiplier setting. So time is not the absolute time, the multiplier. As we discussed last time, that if the current is high, the time low taken to operate the relay will be less. And if current is less, then time will be more. So here, suppose I put a plug setting. One means that is a 100%. The adopt a ratio of 600 ampere, 600 by 130 U. Then beyond 600 ampere, relay will take. Now, suppose at present it is 1.5, so it is 600. Suppose plus setting is 300 or 600 multiplied by 1.5. So whenever the 900 ampere will be current flowing on the primary side of the conductor, that is CT ratio 600, then 1.5 ampere will come in the secondary, and it when it crosses the limit, depending upon its time, it will operate. Now, second is the time multiplier. Here it is a 0.1 second. Now, 0.1 second is not absolute time. Then here, once again, we have a scale. Suppose if 2 times current is then multiplier will be 10. Suppose 3 times current is then, it is less than 6. If it is 4, then like. So if it is 0.1, and if 2 times current is there, so 0.1 multiplied by 10. After 1 second will operate. Similarly, if on this side time setting will increase, and on this side it will decrease. So there are things for the plus setting, second is the time dial, and the time multiplier setting. So this relay will operate, because we know that whenever the normal current is there, it is the order of 400-500 ampere. But when the fault is 5 to 10 times the normal current. So 10 times current will be 5 times. At that time, here, on that scale, whatever the multiplier that, multiplier into time multiplier, that time will operate, will be required to isolate the fault. Now, protection of ring. Last time we understood what is the difference between ring main and radial feeder? Whenever the source is being fed from one end. Whenever the source is fed from both the end, it is called ring main. And whenever the fault is, when any power system is fed from two or more sources from two sides, it is called ring main. So when fault is taking place, fault current will be fed from the two sides. So directional relay are required to be used in load end, and non-directional relay can be at the source end. We can use the at source end, we can use the non-directional relay and thus make it economical. Now time cutting should be done from both the end, at highest at the source and lowest lowest at the farthest end, to avoid the maloperation. So here, whenever whenever two sources are being used to feed the system, or whenever ring mains are there, we have to grade the reacting so that there won't be any maloperation, and so that the only faulty person will be isolated, and healthy and the healthy system will remain in the circuit to feed the load, because the this is the what we require for the thing for purpose of for that purpose we have provided the protection scheme. So grading your backup relay is very important. How we will do that we will see in the next slide. Now here two types of system we have shown. First is a radial system, and second is a ring main system. Now here radial system, the source is one and all the relays are non-directional relay, because there won't be any fault. Suppose fault is taking place at this point, fault in this section, then fault current will be flowing from this. There is no source, so no fault current will be fed from the opposite end. So here we can create like this, suppose 0.125, 0.125, then 0.1, 0.1, 0.075 like this. So whenever the current, suppose whenever there is a fault here, the maximum current will be here, then minimum here, because due to the impedance of the line, total length, the fault current at this point will be less. So less time will be required to operate this relay. Now similarly, whenever there is a fault here, we grade like this, the current will be more than this, but the fault current will be more than this, but it will be less than this. So we have to balance the time so that the whenever fault current is flowing, these relays should not operate. So only point after 0.1 second, immediately it will trip the breaker, and this person will remain healthy. So these two sections will be out of service. Whenever the fault is taking at this place, the maximum current fault will be maximum. So at that point, the current, this timing we have at a graded as a maximum. So 0.125, but as we have seen last slide, that it is a time multiplier. But even though we have kept 0.125, if suppose more 5 to 10 times current is flowing, then it will operate the immediately. So this way we can grade the backup relay in the case of radial system, whenever the fault is being fed from one end. Now we see the grading when the directional relay, ring main system, whenever we use the directional, and generally this is the nomenclature we keep for the non-directional relay, arrow at the both end. Suppose arrow at one end is used, then it will operate in this direction. Whenever fault current is flowing in this direction, whenever the fault is at this place, and the fault current is flowing through this end, this relay will not operate, but this relay will operate. Now we will see the grading of relay in case of whenever we use the ring main system. Now Here the fault, suppose there is a fault here or any section, fault current will be fed from this end and this end also. So we have to first grade the backup relay looking to the one source. Suppose as if the fault is taking place here and fault current will be fed from this end and from this end. So first we have to take the account like this here. Here, this the relay towards this end should be graded first. So here fault current is maximum. So here 0.125. Then here it is 0.1 because the fault current is slightly less due to the impedance added coming in the picture of this line. Now here, so if the fault is taking place, the fault current will be more less than these 2%. So here if it is 0.1, then it is 0.075. Due to the impedance of these two sections. Now when the fault current is here, then still current will be raised. So it is 0.05. So what happened? We have graded the four relay, four directional relay, seeing to the this as a fault, seeing to the source for the giving the fault current. Now when we see this grade this relay, we have to see this as a, our main source for feeding the fault current. So here the fault current will be maximum. So here it will be 0.125. Now when we go on this side, the fault current is still less. So it is 0.1. Then here it will be still, it is will be lower due to this impedance of these two sections. So it is 0.075. And when we come at the last point, it is the lowest of all due to this, all the impedance coming in the picture. So it will be 0.05. So like this, we have to grade the relay, backup relay, so that the mal operation of any relay will not take, faulty operation, so that the healthy portion may not going out. So whenever the fault is taking place here, these two relay will operate because this is the lowest time. So compared to this, similarly this way, similarly this, like this. So accordingly, even though there is a much bigger system, complex system, we should be able to grade the system backup relay so that the whenever fault is taking place, in only faulty relay will operate and other will not operate and feed the remaining system. So this is the grading of ringman and the radial and ringman system. Now how will we wire up in the case of the last time we had seen that this is the thumb rule of any protection system, that we have to do a star formation towards the things which we want to protect. Suppose we want to protect the line, then towards the line CT terminal there, because there, in CT there are two terminals, P1, P2. It is primary P1 and P2. So in P1 we generally keep on bus side and P2 we keep is a line side. So similarly, is correspondingly secondary S1 is a bus side and S2 is line side. So when we use the relay for protecting the line, we form a star point in S2. So it is for the line protection. So this is the common nomenclature we use. When we use for the bus bar, we form a star point the bus bar. So this will be useful for selecting the direction. Now this is also one circuit diagram of the ring main system. Here the source is one, but what happens? Okay, this is a ring main system. Again, whenever the fault is taking place, this current, fault current will flow this point as well as through this point. Even though in previous BSC there are two sources and the fault current will be feeding from two opposite sources, but even though this is the one source, there are two paths available for flowing the fault current. So we have to grade the relay accordingly. Similarly, if we start here, this is here we can use a non-directional relay because there is no other relay behind it. So non-directionally limit, so we can make some system support economical. Then we can reduce the time 2 seconds, then 1.5 seconds, then 1.5, then 1 second, like this. Similarly, 2.5 seconds. So whenever there is a fault, suppose the fault is on taken is here, only two system will, because this is 1.5 seconds. Now here we should understand one, okay, this is the backup relay. So suppose if this faulty section here, there is a fault here, and if this relay operate correctly, if this relay fail to operate due to any reason, so what happens? This is a forward direction, the fault current is flowing in this direction. So anyhow, we have to block this fault current. So here this will work its backup. So this relay will trip and it will stop the current flowing to the fault. And here the current will be flowing to this other direction. So similarly, always the preceding relay will work as a backup relay. Suppose if there is a fault here, or if there is a fault in this section fault is there, and this relay fault current is this correctly operate, but if it does not operate, then this will operate. Why this will not operate? Because it is the back side of the relay, directional relay. So directional relay will operate in forward direction only. If the forward current is flowing in that direction, then only it will operate. In the back side, it will not operate. In the non-directional relay, if the fault current is flowing in the forward as well as reverse direction, so in both the direction it will operate. So here we once again we can see this relay both the direction. This relay can operate for faulty here also. So there is a chance that it may create a maloperation. Suppose if this relay does not operate properly, there is a chance that even though this is a fault healthy section, it may operate because this is a non-direct. While here in this case, what happens? Fixed directions are provided. So whenever there is a fault here, then this is a chance. But if this fails, then only this will operate because we have to block the current, fault current coming from the source. Because fault has to be isolated anyhow by any means. Otherwise, there will be a system disturbance in the grid system. Same diagram, ring main system is example of other ring main system. Where here there is the one generator and this is a transformer and this is a two parallel lines, line one and line two. So whenever there is a fault here, this is a non-directional, but this will operate for this fault and this will operate. For here, the fault current will be varying from this point. So here, fault current will be this way. Both fault current in this direction is same. So this will operate. So fault will be isolated. Now, suppose if this fails, this will not operate because it is in the backward direction. It is so in this direction only. So this will work. This will work. So in that case, this relay will operate and this fault will be isolated. Because as I said, the fault has to be isolated. Here there is a chance that if this isolated, there won't be current to the load. Here also, if this not does not operate in these strips, then here all this system may be isolated due to the due to non-operation of this relay. So otherwise, if both the relays are operating correctly during this fault and this fault, then the other line through other line, the load will be failed. Here also the system, one source and others. Here this is non-directional and these two are the, this is two directions. Here also same thing. So whenever the fault is taking place here, the fault current will be fed from this end and fault current will be fed from this end. So these two relay will operate. If this relay does not operate, then this will have to operate. If this relay does not operate, then this will, like other end relay will work as a backup. And try to isolate the. So in this ringman system, it is a somewhat complex method, and to greatly relay very very carefully. Otherwise, there is always a chance of malfunction. Because in backup, grading needs some effort. Now, if this is two parallel lines, the two relays, backup relays are provided, overcurrent fault relay, the two relays are there's no relay. Now, here the 0.3 and 0.3 setting are provided. Then how will we operate? Once again, the same thing, suppose the fault is actually here, fault current will be flowing to this part and this part. Now, this part is smaller, so the impedance will be less and the fault current will be high. Here, this part is rounded, this large, low. Longer path. So this is a longer path, so more impedance is added. So fault current will be less. And as I told you in the previous slide, that according to the IDMT characteristics, time of operation is depending upon the fault current. Here, fault current is large, so it will be isolated. So when the fault is isolated, there won't be any chance of operation. Now, overcurrent and what fault relay for radial feeder. So we can here save the overcurrent fault relay, and we can place two overcurrent. And because there is a fault, whenever there is a normal situation is there, here fault is flowing, and according to the Kirchhoff's law, the resultant current will be zero. So there won't be any current. But whenever the fault is taking place here or in this person, there will be a resultant current, and the resultant current will be flowing in the fault relay. It will be an isolated form. Now, due to the overloading, suppose if we consider the balanced load system, because this type of system only useful whenever there is a balanced overloading in R phase, Y phase, and B phase, all three phases, the current flowing is same. Then and then this system can be used. Otherwise, slight mismatch is there, which will make this relay operate. So in the overloading, only two phases can be protected. Suppose instead of 300 ampere, suppose load current is increased by 100 ampere, then only these two phases can be saved like this. But because if fault is taking place, there will be a high fault current will be there. If whatever, suppose if this conductor is broken or this conductor is broke, or rather, then more fault current will be flowing, and the resultant of this current will be flowing here, and it will make the hot fault relay operating. Now, as we see, what is the direction of directional relay? There are, last time we discussed what are the ring main views. Told that we discussed it is the over directional relay, and in the radial system we use a non-directional relay. Now see, we'll discuss what is the directional features of the backup relay. Now we said that in AC there is no direction, in DC only we have a fixed direction, the current is flowing from positive to negative. So now that portion we'll try to understand. Current in any conductor of an electric circuit can flow from left to right or from right to left. This is commonly referred as direction of flow of current. So from any direction current can flow. In DC polarity indicates the direction of current flow. However, in AC polarity alternate constantly. So in AC, how do you decide the direction? Polarity cannot be used to determine the direction of flow of current. So this is very important. We do not have any fixed polarity. So how will we decide the direction? So in AC power circuit, one determines the direction of flow of current from phase shift between voltage and the current. Now we can decide the current So direction of current with respect to the voltage. Now forward and reverse direction. So whenever this E is voltage and when current is in on this direction, it is considered as a forward. And if its current is going away this, then we consider be fixed as a reverse current. So similarly here also, this is E means it is a this is the voltage here, both these direction. Here it is, if we consider voltage vector is on this side, then this current will be negative, means it is in the reverse direction. Now this philosophy will be useful for understanding the directional relay. Now directional overcurrent relay 67 refers to relaying that can use the phase relationship voltage and current to determine the direction of the fault. Now with respect to the voltage and current, we can fix this as a directional. So if it is in this direction, then it is an operating zone. On the reverse side, it will be a non-operating zone. Now, as we discussed that with respect to voltage, we will decide the direction of current, which is either forward or reverse. Now, we know that whenever on the line R phase is being grounded, any particular phase, then that R phase earth fault is taking place, then what happens? That voltage will be collapsed. Suppose if it is a 110 volt secondary side, or if it is a full voltage on the 220 and 1, that voltage will be collapsed. So we use which voltage we use. So there are two types of polarization. Polarization quantity is the referencing quantity for us for comparing the direction of current. So first is the voltage of same phase used in the current is known as self-polarization. And cross polarization voltage of other two phase. Suppose whenever there is a R phase is ground, its fault is taking place. So R phase voltage will be reduced, but other two phases will be healthy, Y and B phase. We can make use of other two phase Y and B as a reference for determining the direction of current, and that we call as a cross polarization. Now there are two different methods of determining the or checking or testing the directional relay. So one we have in the field two types of kit. One is the Omicron kit and second is the Doppler kit. So one sample testing thing we'll try to understand here to determine the directional relay features. Now with that particular Omicron kit, we have some angle. Suppose R phase overcurrent is R phase fault is taking place, then we have 45 to 220 degree as the operating region, and on the back side it will as a non-operating region. Similarly, whenever Y phase fault is taking place, and similarly it is from 165 to 345 for B phase. So this is by simulating the fault we can test the relay. Now we'll see how the one as a sample for R phase overcurrent, how actually it will work. Now how will we decide the operating region and non-operating region whenever actual fault is taking place? Now we know that this is a VA, this is VB and VC. This is three voltage. Now what happens? Whenever R phase fault is taking place, then we use Y and B as a reference voltage. We call VBC. So here VB and VC, we extend this line as a reverse direction. And resultant we use as a VBC. So VBC is our reference voltage. Now different relays have different characteristics. This we have considered as the REF relay, REF615. ABB make the directional overcurrent relay. It is a numerical relay. It will see how it looks. So it has a fixed setting of 45 degree towards anti-clockwise. So that we will see the MTS, that is the maximum torque angle line. And on that we draw a 90 degree line to decide the operating region. So this complete region we call as the operating region of this relay. So this is a 45 degree and this is a 225 degree. So this complete region we call as the operating region of the R-phase overcurrent relay. Similarly, second or for B-phase also we can draw vector diagram, and C-phase we can also see a vector diagram to decide the operating region. Because whenever VBS fault is taking place, then at that time VCA will be the reference voltage for deciding the direction of current. And VC for AB. So these two voltage we can find. So 285 to 105 and 165 to 345. So this is for the directional. Now this is for the earth fault relay, because we have in field we have two types of relay: overcurrent and earth fault. Overcurrent R phase, overcurrent Y phase, overcurrent B phase, and earth fault relay. As we discussed in previous slides, the earth fault we keep after the neutral of these all three relay R, Y, and B. So here, if we want to decide how the direction of current, whether it is in the forward direction or it is in the reverse direction. So whenever the VA is taking place, here we find the zero sequence current. So VA plus VB plus VC is equal to zero. That is the vectors cross term. Now whenever the fault is taking place, polarizing voltage VA plus fault is taking place, at that time what happened, VA will be minus VA, here it is become the polarizing voltage, and in the numerical relay, earth fault relay, we have a 135 anti-clockwise setting. So 135 degree we draw one line of maximum torque angle, and on this relay we draw one line on 90 degree on both sides. So this once again this will be a 45 to 225 degree. So this is for the earth fault. But here we difference only here VA, so this is minus VA in earth fault, because it is a polarizing voltage, zero sequence voltage we are using. Now this way we can simulate the other for earth fault also VB, VC, and for overcurrent RYB to decide the operating region and non-operating. So this is the operating region, while these are the non-operating region of the. So this way actual our relay will operate when the fault is taking place. Now, this is with the other Doble kit relay. Here also we have a same philosophy of overcurrent R phase. Similarly, as we have discussed here, VA. So this is the polarizing voltage VBC, and on this is a 45 degree, and on this we draw a 90 degree line. So all this complete will be the operating region, and this is non-operating. So second is also, suppose this is the fault for Y phase. So Y phase we use as a BR. So here it is CA. So again, it is a 45 degree MTA line. On this, it is a 90 degree. So same thing, same philosophy will be used for this. This is a vector only directly coming in the relay. same it is B-phased. B-phased means it is the AB. So AB also this portion, so this portion completely operating region, and this will be again non-operating region. So this way we can understand the direction. Similarly, it is for the earthquake. Now, how the development of protective relay came into picture, that we also understand. In up to 1910, up to electromechanical relay were in picture. No other relay were there. Then in 1960, the static relay came. This is the evolution history of our relays. And in 1980 onwards, still today, we use the numerical relay. Now, development of protective relay, that we also understand. Now, what are the advantages of the numerical relay? Okay, why the numerical relay have some superiority over the other relay? So main at numerical relay, they immune to variation parameter of component, as there are no solid state component like op-amp. Op-amp is the operational amplifier where the heat dissipation was very large, very low burden. This is the great advantage, because one relay we understood in the electromagnetic overcurrent relay, that we discussed the plug setting, time setting, and time multiplier. It was the original backup relay, but it has a great burden. It is having a very high burden. So numerical relay offer very low burden on the CTs and PTN. This is helpful in fulfilling of idea required that sensors should not consume any power. If a sensor consumes power from the quantity measure, it will lead to distortion of other quantity. So this is also the advantage of our numerical relay. Now, flexibility of the compactness. As an example, to provide the magnitude scaling and phase shape, a voltage signal to derive a line-to-line voltage from phase to neutral, which is much simpler with computer relaying, because the equipment can be implemented pre-program. Here, the like computer, we can use any relay. We can make use of any protection by using the programming also, by simple calculation. Because whenever we use the earth fault, we have to create an open delta voltage. So for that, we have to provide the transformer. In olden days, we had to provide the transformer in the relay panel to bring the open delta. So now in numerical relay, this can be done with the help of calculation. So the no separate transformer, only we have to bring the voltage terminal from the yard to the relay. And internally, by modification only, we can use this open delta voltage without using the secondary transformer. So this is also advantage. Also, programming feature including more than one character in a single relay. In olden days, whenever we use the electromagnetic relay, we have a different relay separately. Suppose we have a backup relay, distance relay, separate relays are there. Here in one relay, we can make use of overcurrent, earth fault, then backup relay, distance relay, all different relays can be formed in one only. See, also, generic hardware can be developed for different relays, which is the cost of the equipment. Inbuilt software can be changed to simulate different types of relaying character depending on required. Thus, a flexible relay is realized which can perform all protection functions. So single relay can be used as backup relay as well as distance, overcurrent, undervoltage, directional, distance protection for a transmission. Some of these relays also function as the event of occurrence of years. This is a very important portion. In the electromagnetic relay, the relay only work as a isolation of fault only. It does not measure the fault current. It does not show where the fault is located. So fault locator was not there. It was simply working as a relay to isolate the fault. So here we have event sequence event recorder, then disturbance recorder and fault decoder, so that it will measure the fault and approximately in the vicinity of the fault recorder reading, we may get the fault. So this multifunction relay have made the panels for the protection system very compact. Figure shown in the next illustrates the space saving. Autoreclose scan function is also incorporated in this system. So this is the complete olden electromagnetic relay. This is the distance relay starters, and here backup relay. While here it will work in this only. And this is, these are only a tripping relay for the break. So these are the now latest Alstom backup relay. This is also a REF615 ABB make overcurrent or fault relay. Here we'll see this what is normal current, normal voltage whenever it is current relay is working in the on the line. This is all for settings. These are LED indications for any fault is taking place. That particular LED glow. Now Siemens, once again here also Siemens backup relay. Here it will be a current, normal current, and here voltage. Suppose this is a 12 ampere, this 132 kV line. Here LED, R3, R phase, Y phase, B phase, or fault trip, over current trip, like that. Now this is numerical relay. This is the setting file. Now this is control input like this. Suppose we have a current setting of 0.8 ampere, so 800 milliampere. Time is suppose 0.15, so 1.5, may 115 to 10 raised to minus 3 like this. This is the setting file for this we have to do while configuring the relay. Same way, this is the earth fault relay. Here we keep as a plug setting as a 0.2 and time also setting as a 0.2 also. Now this is the earth fault open delta voltage of the earth fault that I discussed. This is the over current and this is the earth fault relay. Now, what are the limitations of overcurrent relay? So in olden days, the overcurrent relay was very useful, means it was required, but since one century or more than that, we have developed the distance relay. But now, because looking to the criticality of the system, we use the backup relay. Suppose to 66 kV go for the backup relay, but on 30 kV, 400 and above also, we have to go for the distance relay. Now, what are the problems? Now, we see one by one, that there is, suppose they don't, the inverse time and instant in the overcurrent relay are very prone to that as well, the input ratio is to the relay capacity. Now, the source impedance and Z1 is the fault impedance. So here, if the source this ratio is more, then what happens? The fault is not that much enough to strong to feed the fault current. Then there will be a problem. Now, overcurrent relays are active selected by time gradient. This clearly means that time setting will be progressively increased towards the source, and the severe most fault will clear the source. The instantaneous relay with high setting can be increased in time. But we suffer from the problem of transient overcurrent. It is very difficult to calculate the relay setting overcurrent relay in an interconnector. Very involved computers also. There is a very complex system, as we have seen in the previous slide, the grading of time setting. So here it is simpler system, so it can be done. But if it is a very complex system, then it needs very expertise to grade the time. Because whenever the fault is taking place, fault is from both the source, and if it is a very complex system, very large, then it is very difficult to grade the system. Now, whenever fault line is very low due to the weak source or fault at a distance, then it will come to local. So here, it's, then at that time, earth fault only can be. Whenever there is a, because if this overcurrent will totally depend on the fault current. So fault, if fault current is source is very strong, it should be, if it is not able to feed the very strong fault current, then that create a problem. It will may consider the load current if fault current is very long. Overcurrent relay can isolate fault only if distance cannot be known. So the complete relay has to be factored here. It will work only as isolating the fault, as we have seen. So this year also the disadvantage. The continuity of supply cannot be maintained at the load and in the event of fault. The continuity of supply cannot be maintained the load and in the event of fault. Because in the distance protection, we may use the auto-reclose features. Suppose if there is a transient fault is there, fault came in, went away, gone away immediately. At that time, if the backup relay is used, overcurrent or fault relay, it will only isolate the fault and completely be able to patrol the line. And unless we attend the fault, we can only take the test charge, but that also makes sense in the system. But if it is a distance protection along with the auto reclose, if it is a transient fault, then it will trip, try to reclose, and if it is transient, it remains closed down. So no need disturbance in the grid system. So time lag is provided, which is not desirable. In short circuit. Here what happens, it is backup in the relay in that time dependent system. So what happens is there is a heavy short circuit that also depends upon the time, because there are two things, plus setting and min setting. And it is a time multiplier. It is difficult to coordinate required change with audition. It is not suitable for long distance and where the fault is necessary for its stability. Now we will switch over to other important thing, relay, and that is called the distance relay. Distance protection of transmitter. Now what is the distance? The meaning of distance protection, the relay whose working depends upon the distance between the impedance of faulty section and the position on which the relay is installed is called a distance relay, that is V by N. Suppose whenever the fault is here, then we measure the distance from this point. So the fault impedance, it will not measure the current, not measure the voltage, but it will measure the voltage upon current. So whenever the fault is taking place, the voltage will be less, voltage reduced, and current will be high. Current will be very, very high, as we discussed, it's more than 5 to 10 times. So in normal case, what happens, voltage will be very high and current will be less. Suppose it is 220 kV line, at 220 kV into 10 raised to 3, support current, suppose 300 to 400 ampere, so it will be more than that. So it is a very high impedance. But because when the fault is taking place, the voltage will be collapsed and current will be high, at that time the impedance will be very low. And if that impedance comes under the impedance at this point, then it will operate. So it only measures the impedance, it is not the current dependent. So it measures distance between the impedance of faulty section on which the relay installed is, it measures on this impedance of the line. So it is the distance from this distance, this line, because as the distance varies, the impedance varies. Now these are the modern type of numerical relay. It is also make distance relay. This is also a Siemens make relay. Now as we had discussed last time, like backup relay, we have also the different characteristics of different scheme. So we will try to understand what are the different characteristics. So first is the reactance, impedance, mo, offset, and norm. Now, apart from starting from the reactance, we have latest quadrilateral characteristics with the all numerical relays. Now, there are three types of line. One is a short transmission line. Second is a medium transmission line and long. That we have a 60 to 80 kilometers, then 60 to 160 or say 180, and around more than 160 kilometer we have a long transmission line. Now we have different characteristics that we will see one by one, and we will try to understand what are the difference between them and why latest we use the quadrilateral. So it is a reactance characteristic. So a reactance characteristic is on line on the y-axis, and there is no on x-axis. Now this is the positive region, and this is the above this is negative region. So if the reactants come under, whenever come under this section, it will operate, and beyond this point, it will not operate. Second is the impedance diagram. So impedance diagram also a circle around the center as a here origin, and so on the both all four quadrants. So within this is the operating region, and within this it is a restraining region or a negative term. It will not operate this way. So whatever the impedance coming around this point, it will operate. Now more relay. So this is also a latest relay. Now more relay have, this is the suppose our impedance line of the our transmission line, impedance of the transmission line, and this is suppose arc resistance, and this is the final our impedance, fault impedance. Now it is the circle passing through the center origin, so it is only one quadrant. Here it is in all quadrant, it is impedance in all quadrants. So in any of the quadrant fault is taking place, it will operate. While here it is only in this portion only it will operate, and beyond this point it will not operate. Now offset mow is like the circle beyond the below the zero line origin. What is the significance of this? It is to back up to the bus bar scheme. Or whenever the fault is taking place on the rear side of the CT, so that will operate after the three and time delay 300 millisecond or the zone 3 time. So to work as a backup of the bus, if backup or a bus bar does not operate or if bus bar not provided, then there is a chance that it will take care of this type of fault. And this is the quadrilateral characteristic which we use in nowadays in the field with all numerical relays. The major advantage of this relay, it has the specific Z as well as X and R characteristics. And this is useful whenever the earth fault is taking place. Now we have the comparison of reactants used for the short transmission line, non-directional, no effect of arc resistance, and short line power carrying capacity less but large area covered in RX plane, hence small operation due to the power swing observed, no tripping on resistance. It only measures the reactance, so it has no effect on the effect on the fault earth resistance. So it can be used in the short line, because our majority of our fault is of the single phase to ground fault. So we cannot use on the medium line or long line. Cannot distinguish the fault in the area because it is on the both side of the origin, both side of the origin, zero. So it may on the right side or it may on the work on the operate in the left side. Second characteristic is the impedance. It is used for the medium line and non-directional, because it's circle passing through on the four quadrant. The effect of arc resistance goes in under reach. Now, moderate area in RX, so moderate become maloperation due to power swing. Now, what is more characteristic used for the long transmission line? And before the quadrilateral came into picture, we used to use the more relay, as in our all electromagnetic relay or digital static relay, directional relay, more effect of power swing or auto arc resistance result into under reach. less area covered in, so no mal operation due to power switch. So it is small area, so power swing will be go into outside. Due to the power swing used for the phase fold, wide used in application in the numerical relay also. Now offset more respond to both resistance and reactance. So fold location is possible. Low line length cannot be used. Now offset more characteristic, but below zero, so fold near the bus or the back side of city can be isolated. Now quadrilateral. Quadrilateral can be used in program based relay. On top line covers the reactance, bottom line covers the resistance. So phase to phase and phase to earth. So main advantage is we have a separate setting for resistance as well as for the impedance for the X and R. Now we, as we discussed in the previous slide, that some particular relay have effect on arc resistance. So now we'll try to understand what is the arc resistance actually is. So it is a flashover from phase to phase or phase to ground occurs, then arc resistance is introduced into fault path and the arc resistance is appreciable on a higher voltage. Arc resistance is added to the impedance of the line, hence the resultant which seen by the relay is increased in case of ground fault of the resistance of earth fault is reduced. The earth fault resistance includes the resistance of tower, tower putting resistance, earth and earth return source. So earth resistance and arc resistance combined as a fault impedance. So whenever the fault is taking place, phase to ground, then arc resistance is introduced in the fault. The arc resistance is appreciable at higher voltage, which is added to the internal line and the resultant is seen by the resistance. That we will see in the next slide. Now fault resistance. Now here, if we see here, that whenever the fault F is there, if this arc resistance is there, and see ZF R will come in the picture, it just touches the circle. But if this is the R, suppose if this, there is no arc resistance, or arc resistance is less, then the complete line, this impedance line will be protected as a fault impedance. But due to the arc impedance, this fault seen by the relay will be reduced, and that is called the underreach of the scheme. Otherwise, what happens if we try to protect this fault impedance here in same arc resistance, this line will go result and will be outside. So here, due to the arc resistance, our actual reach will be reduced. That is the main problem. Now, three-step characteristics. In distance protection, there are three zones, zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. So zone 1, first zone will be 80% to 90%, 80% we keep, and remaining 20% plus next 50% of the adjacent line is a zone 2, and remaining portion as a zone 3. So it is called so a three-step distance protection point. Now we'll see, we have seen the characteristics, different characteristics we use is the distance protection. Now we see the setting, how generally we see the, do the setting in our distance protection. It is a, only for the simple method for understanding. It is not as simple as we have seen here, but it is for the sake of understanding. Now we have this system, suppose CCPP or Dhuaran line to Kasor, and from Kasor two line, one is a Botar and another is a Kasor line, Karamsad line, one is a Botar. So what happens, this is line we have to protect here, this is 52.7, then it is a 144, and this from Kasor to Karamsad is, it is only a 12.5. Now we'll do how we will do the setting of the zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3. Now zone 1 is always 80% plus instantaneous. It will operate trip instantaneously. If the fault is in the first 80% from both the sides, from here 80% and from here 80%. Now 20% plus 50% of the shortest adjacent line will be covered in 300 milliseconds, and zone 3 will be covered in 750 milliseconds. So now we'll see how we will do the setting. Now calculation sample for. Now we have a 600 by 1 is a CT ratio and PT ratio 220 kV by 100. So this is on the primary side. Now we have to convert in the secondary side by doing the multiplication CTR by PTR. So if we do the CTR upon PTR, then the 0.3, because we are doing the setting on the relay on the secondary side, on actual current and voltage on the primary side. So we have to convert in the secondary. Now what is the impedance of the line? So it is a 52 point. So the impedance of the protected line is 52.7, 0.406. It is the ohm per kilometer of the Mohs conductor or a zebra cone. We have a different conductor used in different lines. So according to line parameter, we have impedance, reactance like this. So it is 0.40. It will be 21.39 multiplied by 0.3. It is the CTR upon PTR. The 6.418. Now we use the zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 settings. Suppose 6.418 multiplied by 0.1, it is 5.13, 80% of PS. PS means protected section. Now zone 2. Zone 2, how will we do? So 12.5, because it is the 50% of the smallest line. Here only we have one line, but if we more than that, we have to take the 50% of the adjustment line, adjacent smallest line. So 12.5 into 0.4 is 0.3, it is 0.5. 0.5 is why 50%. Then this comes 6.415. 6.415 means this. This is the 100%, 50% plus adjustment, it is 7.17. Now third is 100% of protected plus 100% of long line. So 100% of protected 6.418 plus 144 is this longest line, 144, Botar. So 144 into 0.406 into it is 23, so it is the 100. And zone 4, 0.1 of the zone 1 for the reverse side. In zone 1, how much it is? 5.1, which 0.1 is 0.15. This way we have to do the setting of zone 1, zone 2, zone 3 and zone 4. This is the only a simple, only to make you understand how the setting is being done. In time also it is zone 1 is a instantaneous, it has no setting. But zone 2 it is a 300 millisecond, zone 3 is also 750 and zone 3 is also a 750 millisecond. So this is a plug setting and time setting can be done. In numerical other relay, we have the resistance setting also, we have the different make the different relay, we have a different type of. This is only a simple calculation showing how the setting can be done. Now complete DPA scheme for phase 2 and phase 4. Now we have other features of so DPS. The main two features, it is the settings and the characteristics. Characteristics, we have seen different characteristics. Now we have a different features. Now what are the features? Carrier incorporating scheme. Now we have seen here, okay, suppose 80% of the line is there, then it will trip instantaneously. But in the zone 2, it will become 20% plus. Why we keep 80%? That is also an issue. Why we cannot protect complete line instead? Because due to the CT mismatch or BT mismatch, because it is measuring the CT current and then PT current. Due to any mismatch, there is a chance of overreaching of the line. So there is a chance due to CT or PT, you may measure this impedance. And suppose if it measures, then the healthy line may trip. So there is a chance that suppose if you take a zone 1 reaches a 3 ohm, and if you by mistake, if you measure the 3.2 or 3.5, there is a chance that the other healthy line also may trip. So overreaching also can be possible due to this. So we keep a factor of safety is at 20%, so that due to CT mismatch or PT mismatch, the healthy line may not trip. So this way, we keep the 80%. Now 20% and the remaining 50% zone 2, we keep as a time setting as a 300 milliseconds. Now what happens, suppose the 20% remaining, if there is a fault in remaining 20%, then the fault will be fed for 300 milliseconds. And this is not desirable. And in any extra high voltage critical line, suppose 220, 400 kV or a 750. So what we do, we use a carrier added scheme, and that is called carrier added protection scheme, in which whenever the fault is in this carrier added scheme, when the fault is taking the middle of the protection line, suppose both the end relay will operate zone 1 and send the carrier signal to opposite end. Suppose if there is a 100 kilometer line and the fault is taking place 50, both the zone 1, then both will operate instantaneously and send a carrier signal to opposite end. Both will receive the carrier signal at their end. When the fault is taking very nearer to one end, is less than 20, suppose from one end it is 90%, so this will, here it is zone 1, so it will operate in zone 1 and trip the breaker instantaneously. Now, this will operate and send a signal to opposite end. So, what happened? So suppose if fault is taking place here, so this will operate instantaneously and the carrier signal will be sent here. And on the receipt of carrier signal, this will, without waiting for zone 2 time, it will trip the breaker instantaneously. So this is the carrier added scheme. There is the area, that particular area trips zone 1 instant and send the carrier signal to opposite end. But this scheme is called carrier permissive under this scheme. So what is the importance of permissive there? What is the importance of permissive? That there must be a definite fault on the line. If there is only carrier signal is sent, but there is no fault, then there is a one fault starter is contact is used in the circuit. So whenever the starter contact is closed, and if receives a signal from the opposite end, then line will be tripped. Otherwise, if there is a maloperation of carrier, then it will not trip because starter contact has not closed. As there is a definite fault on the line, remote end relay will starter pick up, and on receipt of the signal from opposite end, this relay will trip instantly. Thus, both ends will trip instantly, even though the fault is on too. When there is a fault outside the protection, beyond the remote and relay cable will not be sent to the opposite end, it will not operate. So behind the protective section, if fault is taking place, it will not operate. Here, once again, it is seen. So if it is this is sent and this is received, this is sent and this is received. Now here it is understood one by one that how the carrier under this scheme, suppose whenever the fault is taking place in the middle of the section, the both the sections, station A and station B, both will send a signal, receive the signal and trip the breaker. Suppose this is a carrier send signal. Because whenever the fault is taking place in zone 1, both will send a signal. So this contact will close, starter is there, it will close. So here it will send the signal. This is the carrier receive relay operate, and it will, this is also zone 1, so this will close. Because this is also zone 1, so this contact is closed. There is a depth. Definite fault on the line, so this is a fault detector, it will close and this will contact close, so by this way also operate, and by this way it will go 86 to trip the breaker. Here also this is relay operate, this relay will operate this way, and here the fault is there, so this will contact and this will trip the breaker. Suppose the fault is zone 2, very near to the station B and very remote from the station A. So what happens? This will operate in zone 1. So this stand relay will operate. Starter will operate because there is a definite fault on the line. So this will contact close and it transmit the signal to the opposite end. And this relay will receive the contact. And this contact will be closed. Now, from this positive will come on this side. Now, FD1, there is a definite fault, so fault detector, and it will take the breaker. Now, this carrier send will not operate because it is zone, fault is zone 2. But FD1 will be operate because there is a definite fault on the line. So, this contact closed, but as this coil is operate, this contact closed, and this way, this will operate and trip the breaker 86 instantaneously. So even that the fault is at the very near to the station B, both the relay will be, breaker will be tripped instantaneously. So in the critical line, we cannot afford to feed the fault more than 20 to 40 20 milliseconds. So in that case, we provide the carrier at extreme. Now we see the other features. VT fuse fails. Whenever any secondary fuse fails, it becomes similar to the single phase to ground fault. So whenever the R phase fuse is blown off, in the case of secondary fuse, so it becomes that there is no phase voltage. So after reset time, 5 seconds, the distance relay will be blocked to avoid the maloperation. So this is also an important feature that whenever there any fuse is blown off, we have to block the distance scheme. So we have to replace the fuse and normalize the scheme. Now broken conductor. So whenever secondary wire in the CT gets open or any primary conductor on the line found broken, BRC will appear on fascia only, but it will not give any tripping to the line. So this can be only alarm only because any conductor is broken. Unless it falls on the ground, if the relay will not operate to isolate the fault. But by anyhow, if there is a one of the current becomes less or any secondary wire is opened in the CT, at that time also this feature may come to say that we have to switch off the line and isolate the fault. Now SOTF. So it is also important feature because sometimes what happens during the outage, when you use the maintenance of the line, so any earthing remain pending on the isolator or any line on any phase, R phase, Y phase, or B, or if we try to switch on the line, at that time SOTF will come, switch on to fault. So it will immediately trip the line without any time delay, and that reaches up to the zone 2. So switch on to fault is used to provide the high speed tripping when energizing a power line under fault condition, that is earthing persisted on the line. At the time of line made on and there is a fault in zone 2, then more time to be required to clear the fault. To reduce the fault time, SOTF used and whenever fault in zone 2 at the time of line made on, treated as a zone 1 and clear it. So whenever any persisted fault is there during the switching on, it will trip the line. Now auto-reclose. So auto-reclose is also very important feature on the distance protection. That there are two types of fault on the line. One is a transient fault and other is a permanent fault. So whenever there is a permanent transient fault, we need not isolate the line permanently. So we make use of the auto-reclose feature of the line and do not disturb the grid. So that because whenever there is a 400 kV line or 750 or a very bulk quantity of power is being given to the load or station, at that time, it is not advisable that due to this very small fault, we trip the complete line. So there are different type of features, a single phase fault, single phase fault, the single phase trip, and single phase close, and three phase fault or three phase fault. Suppose there is a transient fault. So suppose if there is due to the wind, any tree is coming in the vicinity of the conductor, and it immediately going away. Suppose the R phase, Y phase, and B phase. The R phase, if it is coming in the vicinity of R phase, then R phase will trip. Then it will try to reclose. And if it is a temporary only transient fault, then R phase will close again without disturbing Y and B phase. So R phase, Y phase, and B phase will be continuous as it is. But if it is a permanent fault, then R phase trip, R phase close, and all three phase will trip like this if it is a permanent fault on the R phase. So here what happens, see, it will take one chance to reclose. If it stands, then it will reclose all as it is, otherwise it trips all the phases. In the auto reclose relay, we have two settings. One is a date timer and one is a reclaim timer. Date timer is for closing time of the breaker, it is just 800 milliseconds, and reclaim time is 20 seconds. Now what is the significance of reclaim timer? Suppose my line has came in the vicinity of the, means one tree is came in the vicinity of the one of the phase, suppose R phase or a Y phase or B phase, and immediately going away, so that particular phase will trip and then reclose again, and line will be normal. But before 20 seconds, if same tree came again, then it will trip permanently. Then it will not take chance to reclose, because it is, if continuously it is coming near and coming, going away, coming near, then there will be a hunting in the breaker. So before 20 seconds, if the same key or same fault is taking place, then it will trip the breaker for all three phases. So there is two things: reclaim time, once only coming, and after 20 seconds if coming again, then it will stand. But before 20 seconds, if that fault is reappearing on the line, even though it is a transient, it will trip the breaker. So if there is, then this is only for single fault we provide in the field. But if it is two phase fault, then it will trip the breaker immediately for three phase fault. Now power swing. Power swing is defined as the oscillation in active and reactive power flows in the transmission line consequent of large disturbance like a fault. Oscillation in the apparent power and bus voltage are seen by relay, the impedance swing on the RX plane. If the impedance trajectory enters the relay zone, if it stays there for sufficiently long time, then the relay will issue a trip decision to the power swing. Tripping on power swing is not there. Now, whenever the fault is taking place on the line, there is a disturbance creating in the system. It is called a power swing. It is just a net. Anybody jumping on the net, it will have a swing on the system. So it is like a disturbance in the system whenever. But that power swing, whenever that system, that it of two types, it is of a recovery type or permanent type. Suppose it enters in our characteristics, it stays for long time, more than 2 seconds, then in that particular circle, in particular zone 1, zone 2, or zone 3, it will trip with that much time delay. But it comes and going away, then it will not trip it immediately. Suppose it will go away immediately, then it will not trip the line. That depends upon the setting. Power swing may cause the impedance presented to adjacent relay to move from the normal load area into the relay characteristics. In case of a stable power swing, it is especially important that the distance relay should not trip. In case of a not allow the power system to return to stable condition. For this reason, most protection scheme apply to transmission system with power swing blocking. So there are two different method of power sink. Power sink has a block as well as power sink has a sinking. Different manufacturing utilities do two things. Suppose zone 1, zone 2 and zone 3. Suppose if power sink enter into the zone 2 or zone 3, then we block the power sink, block the tripping. But when we comes in the zone 1, it will keep the line. Some utility have a 2 second time. Suppose power sink comes and going away, and it will not trip, but it remains there for more than 2 seconds, then it will trip the line. So that we have to follow the setting according. So any disturbance taking place in the system is considered as a power sink because it has the voltage and current. But the difference between the power sink and the fault is like that. Fault is the effect phenomena, power sink is the slow phenomena. Now, what is the disturbance recorder? So whenever the fault is taking place, we have a graphical chart. So one is a E phase voltage, B phase voltage, C phase, then neutral voltage. Similarly, I A phase current, D phase voltage current, C phase current, and neutral current. So whenever the disturbance normal voltage is there, this type of phenomenon. But whenever the voltage is being disturbed, at that time this will be like this. So this is the neutral voltage. Suppose whenever the system voltage are same, the neutral voltage will be zero. But here there is a fault. So then whatever the voltage is appearing in the neutral voltage. Similarly, this is the current. And we have two channels in the disturbance recorder. One is the analog channel, and the other is the disturbance channel. So these relays are provided, they will become this thicker line. That particular relay is operated. This red is that particular relay.
યસ સર
હા હવે આપણે શું ફર્ધર પેલું એક અકરન્સ રિપોર્ટ જોવે છે કે હવે આ ડિસ્ટન્સ પ્રોટેક્શન નું પૂરું થશે એલડીબી નું છે હવે કેટલું લેવું છે
સર આઈ થિંક ટાઈમ તો ઓવર થઈ ગયું છે આપણે 11:52 ની આસપાસ થયું છે
હા બીજો કલેક્ટ હવે જો અકરન્સ રિપોર્ટ જોવો હોય તો જોઈએ નહીતર પછી રહેવા દઈએ માથાથી
હા એન્ડ કરીએ સાહેબ કેમ કે ટાઈમ 5-10 મિનિટ હોય છે હા
રિપોર્ટ તો થતો હોય તો હું બતાવી દઉં કેવી રીતનું હોય છે
ઓકે કઈ વાંધો નહીં
હા